shall all take your seats.
Is that fair?
Yeah.
Okay, you'd like to take the seats. And we've been in for a treat this morning because we've got our youngsters performing for you. Performing for you. I guess it's an accelerate junior. Performing. So it's going to be a great time. But before we start, we are lighting our Advent candles. A bit like an Advent calendar, but you've got it home where you open the doors, and guess what? Behind it, you've got chocolates behind there. On your countdown to Christmas, we light the Advent candles. And it just gives us a countdown to Christmas, and it lets us focus on Christmas. So I'm going to light the third candle. And just tell you a little bit about it before we start. Pop your light. Okay, the third candle just represents the waiting for Christmas, the waiting that the Lord Jesus was born. It's the waiting, and it some people say it's the candle of John the Baptist, which was sent ahead of Jesus, which was born to Elizabeth, and to prepare the way for the Lord Jesus to come into this world. So, we just go up and pray. What we're going to do this morning, I'm just going to tell you, just give you some idea of what's going to happen today. We're going to sing a few songs, all of us, going to sing a few carols, and then the children that will come up and actually perform for us. And we've got some great, as I said, I'm really excited by it this morning. And then it's going to be a short story, and then some more carols. And then we got Christine to join us for a cup of tea and coffee. And we got a few surprises for the ones. So is that okay? Is that okay today? Yeah? That's all that's going to happen today. So let's just open in prayer. Heavenly Father, we just thank you and praise you and bless you. And we just pray that you be with us this morning as we celebrate the coming of the Lord Jesus. Amen.
Thank you. Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly hosts appeared to the angels praising God, saying, glory to God in the highest, high in heaven, and on earth, to those on whom his favor rests. When the angel had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherd said to one another, let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about.
Thank you.
bright and amazing. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to him. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that had heard, they had heard and seen, which was just as they were told.
Thank you.
Wow. That is, stay up a minute.
Oh, just stay up a minute.
Thank you.
Just a minute.
Let's give them a round of applause again. Guys,
Ruby's going to just play
ball.
Right, I'm going to play your ball. Take it away, Ruby.
These people can help as well, but we've got to stand back position to make one move. Okay? So, can we help them?
Mashkirts.
Yeah?
One move.
You should reach out. Okay. You need to move across. You need to make a word out of it. Come on.
I know what the word is. Do these know what the word is?
Well, can you show them to put in there?
Yes.
I can't do this on my own.
Stop.
I can't spell very well, so. Tell the names. And you can tell them which names are where. Yeah? Right. Right, we've got, that's good, turn it around. Keep it that way, yeah. Keep your number right. So what is it spelling?
Christmas.
Wow. Now, I want you all to stand back in the line. Now, guys, you've got to be good at this now, right? We're going to test you to something. On the back of your letter is a number. No? Right? What's your number?
One.
What's your number?
Two.
What's your
three.
Number? What's your number? What's your number?
Five.
What's your number?
Six.
No, seven. Alright? We can help you, don't worry.
Eight.
And nine. Right. Now remember what your numbers are, because as I'm telling the story, I am going to tell you the numbers that I want to come forward. Okay? So it's quite easy. If I said number 1 and 2, 1 and 2 steps up it and lowered it up high so anybody can see it. Is that cool? Yeah? Alright. So can we start back? And then when the numbers, it should work if I got the numbers right. Never mind. Okay. Well, we've got to be talking about Christmas. Yeah? Christmas is a bit more than just unwrapping. Yeah? As we saw, we unwrapped letters. So we start to unwrap Christmas. So, number three, can you walk forward? And number 8. And number 7. Okay, go that way. Number 8. Oh, I got that wrong. Number 1. You get the story. Right, hold it up and ask them what they say. What do that say?
Cram.
And, you know, Christmas, there's so much to do at Christmas, and we cram our time in, don't we? We cram in time to go Christmas shopping. There's so much to do. Going to get turkey, going to get... I'm always rushing around on Christmas Eve buying things for my wife. You know, that's a man's thing, I know. But, you know, we cram so much in, don't we? To move back. Yeah? Okay. Back in place, okay? And then, number 1, number 2, number 8 again. Yeah? And then, and number 3, and number 7. Number 7. Hold it up. Hold it up. Other way. Your numbers on. You show it. What? Ask them what they say.
Charm.
You know, Christmas is about charm, isn't it? Yeah? Tradition, isn't it? It's a lovely time, isn't it? You know, we put all in decorations. We put up all lights. We've got decorations up. Some of them are not really on others, but by now we should all have our decorations up for Christmas. Yeah? And we even got family traditions that happen, don't they, at Christmas time. It's about charm, isn't it? Okay, we will go back. Okay? Number 1? Number 2? Number 5? Yeah? And number...
You got an answer? Number 2 is your answer. Sorry.
My fault, so number 8 again. Number 8's getting a lot of work in here.
Number 8, come in here. Come in here.
Hold up your letters again. Christmas is about
cash.
Cash. rubbish, isn't it? You know, we all want to spend at Christmas, don't we? Yeah? You know, presents. You know, it's a time. It's a time when Christmas seems to cost a lot more and more each time. Ask your parents. In my days, I used to have a bike which was the largest present. Orange and apple. No. And, but now, you know, we was only speaking this week to some of the youth, how much money they have in for Christmas. One said they amount of £250. And there's more. Yeah? So it's a demand, isn't it? Christmas is a demand on our cash. Yes? It's a demand on our cash. Cash, not crash, not wealthy. Okay, stand back. And I've got number six to come forward. Okay? Number three. Okay, you're getting it now. Number eight. Again, number eight. Number five. Who's five? Yeah. And number two. Who's two? Older. Older. What do that say?
Trash.
Trash. Trash. You know, you see the same old programs, don't be on TV. Same old programs on TV. All repeats. It's Christmas, yeah? We could say, you know, there's a lot of trash that we see at Christmas, isn't it? And don't forget, all the paper on Christmas Day. Yeah? I was talking to the man across the refuge, recycling plant, and he said, Boxing Day, after Boxing Day, the next 3 days are just mad because everybody is bringing trash. Everybody brings trash out. Okay, step back. Step back. You're getting this now, you're going to be there now. Now, number five. Number five. Who's number five? Five, come forward. Number two. Who's number two again? Number two. Number eight. Number eight. Okay. And number seven. Yeah. Oh, yeah. For some people, sadly, we end up putting on a front, don't we, at Christmas? We put on a front, don't we? We you know, we pretend to be nice to people we haven't seen for ages. Even relatives, don't we? You know, we want the perfect Christmas, don't we? The perfect Christmas. And sometimes we can put a sham on, yeah? To try and, you know, it can be a sham for some people. Right, go back. I've got to speed up a little bit now. I've got to speed up, otherwise you'll be falling asleep. But then why? Five? Number five? Number seven? Number eight? Number three? And number six? And what have we got? Smart. You know, isn't it? Who's smart today?
Me.
I have a new jumper to come today. In my new Christmas jumper. And you all are like, look smart today. I don't know about your parents, but no. I'm only joking. You all look smart today, don't worry. We all look smart at Christmas, don't we? We get up on Christmas Day and we put on our best clothes to come to church, I hope. And I just flagged it anyway. But we all like Christmas, don't we? We all like to be smart at Christmas. Don't you guys like to be smart at Christmas?
Yeah.
Let's take a step back. Number one, quickly. Number three. Number eight. Number five. And number two. What we got? Crash. You know, who likes a crash out for Christmas? After that turkey, after them sprouts, after all the things at Christmas dinner, what do we do? And we've done all the jobs, parents and granddads and aunties and uncles, we've done everything to prepare. We are exhausted, don't we? And we've been up since 4 o'clock, because after Christmas is coming, and they've been up to 4 o'clock, we crash, don't we? We crash over Christmas. Yeah? We crash. Okay, let's get back. And what? Number one again, quickly. No, number two, sorry. My apologies.
Number four. Come on, quickly. Put your hands up. And number five. I got a tea missing somewhere. Who's number three? Come on, moving in. We've got it. Yeah? Eight, right? T-S? Listening to music and wondering what this could be Christmas number one. Actually, I always used to think that. Now that it's all online, it's not sort of the same, is it? But do you remember, in my days, it was Top of the Pops? Christmas Day, Top of the Pops. Who was number one? Yeah? And we used to wait for that number one to be revealed. Yeah? Okay, let's get back. Let's get back. We're coming to the end now. Okay, number six. Six. Quick. Number three. Number four. Number seven. What have we got? Trim. As we said before, about the decorations, all the trims that go with Christmas, all the trims that go with your Christmas dinner. So much in there when we're looking at this list. There's so much. Yeah? Okay, back now. And then we're going to really talk now about the real meaning of Christmas. We're going now to talk about the real meaning of Christmas. Most of that is how we see Christmas. How we see how Christmas is. But if I could bring number one up. Number two. Number eight. Number three. Number six. Number five. What have we got?
Chance.
We're not talking about the Christmas top 20 year. We're not talking about that. But the chance was studied once upon a time by the wise men. Remember, the wise men studied chance. And people far away in the east. And then, put people back. Five, six. Eight and three. We're talking about what we're talking about? The star that guided the shepherd, that guided the men to where Jesus was being born. Yeah? Or had been born in Bethlehem. Stand back now. And number two. Four and seven. What about say? In. It's about in. It's about the baby Lord Jesus lying in the manger. It's about the baby that was sang about. Yeah? That we saw. Yeah? See? In the bed of straw, isn't it? Yeah? Yeah? See him lying in the bed of straw. In. The baby lying in the manger. Christians believe that this is a real marvel. We believe that. And it's a miracle of Christmas. And then, for most people, Christmas is felt like this. So can we just go back in your places? And I've got two more to do. Right? And I want one, two, three, five. And the end one. And what does that say? Oh yeah, absolutely. People can see it. Yeah? There is missing letters there, isn't it? There is missing letters. What are the missing letters? Are the missing letters come forward? The ones who have come here? Come here. Oh, that the eye? Like that. And then the space. And hold it like that. No, do the three, put the other ones down at the back. The missing letters are I am. I am missing. Yes? These are the letters that come out right to the very front. Yeah? Might we too
get to unwrap Jesus this Christmas. Amen? Okay, guys, we're all there. I've got something to do after. You've done really well. You've done really well. Can we give them a clap? We're going to sing a couple of songs, two songs now, and then we're going to, we've got something for the children, so don't dash off until your children have received their hard work. They've had some really done some hard work this year, and we want to share that with you, but we want to as well. We want to, on behalf of the team that meets with your young children every week, we want to say, thank you. Thank you for sending your children to us. Because it gives them an opportunity, a good grounding. And we would love to see you on any of our Christmas concerts this Christmas time. We've started this week with this Christmas concert, but we've got another one on Thursday. Who's coming to Thursday? Who's singing with the school? Yeah, we've got the school singing up on Thursday, and we've got a family service on the 24th, and then on the 25th, we've got an half-hour service. So we would love to see it. We would love to see it. So we extend our invitation to you guys for that Christmas. Could I have the worship team back here, please?
Yeah. you all the glory, for you are worthy of everything, Father God. We thank you for our young people, Lord. We thank you, Lord, that you have blessed us with this community, Lord. We thank you for them. And we pray, Father God, that we can just remember the real reason for this season. Lord, I just ask, Lord, as we go our separate ways, that you bless us and keep us safe. In the mighty name of Jesus, amen. Amen. Thank you.